Today I'd like to talk about the 2014 year and economy in review. I'm going to post an article by Dimensional Fund Advisors, and that's their deep dive look at the economic and the market review for the year. Generally speaking, the U.S. had a pretty good year, both in the economy and in the stock market. But the news cycle and the stock market were very out of sync. You may recall back in January, the market was declining and people were starting to become afraid. And the news was saying, oh, market jitters. And that was about the time the market turned around and started going higher. Towards the end of the year, there was another set of jitters as the Federal Reserve started to wrap up their quantitative easing program. But when they finally did wrap it up, again, the market took off. So it was almost like a buy on the rumor and sell on the news sort of phenomenon. Never get too wrapped up into what you're reading versus what the market's doing. I'd like to remind everybody that the market is a leading economic indicator and it knows what's going on before the newspapers do, or you and I do, generally speaking. Whereas the large cap stocks went up about 13% in the U.S., small cap stocks, small company stocks, only went up about 5%. So a big difference, large company doing much better than small company this year, which is contrary to what happens over the longer period of time. Generally speaking, smaller caps are expected to outperform larger caps over time. So we're taking that opportunity to rebalance out of larger cap into smaller cap at the current time. Internationally, did not look so well. More slowdowns in the economy, more noise, more terrorism going on in Europe. And the global index ex-US was actually down about 4.5%. Again, though, the news cycle and the actual market, very inconsistent and hard to match up. The reason I bring these points up, and you can read this article in detail, is that we believe in diversification. In a nutshell, diversification takes the guesswork out of investing. We establish a strategic asset allocation and we stick to it. And then when things get out of balance, we will rebalance back to that allocation. All these different asset classes are expected to produce good returns over time, not at the same time, but we're not going to get out of international and into large cap US just because in one year, one did better than the other. You never know which markets will outperform from year to year, but by holding a globally diversified portfolio, investors are positioned to capture returns wherever they occur. Here is a chart or a table on different asset classes over different periods of time. In this example, from 1999 through last year, 2013, I would like to draw your attention to emerging markets, which is the teal color. Starting in 2007, it was the best performing asset class, the worst performing in 2008, the best performing in 2009, middle of the pack in 2010, worst in 2011, best in 2012, worst in 2013, and back to the middle of the pack in 2014. Which is not on your table. There is no way to guess how it's going to do year to year. So don't chase your tail, but own an asset allocation, strategic allocation of emerging markets and rebalance out of it when it's doing great into it when it's doing poor, and you will improve your returns and always have exposure to this really great asset class over time. Real estate investment trusts were in the middle of the pack in 2013 at about 1.2%. Well, they were the best performing asset class this year at about 30% return. Contrasting real estate investment trusts with against commodities, whereas REITs were the best performing, commodities were the worst for the year, down 17%, largely on falling oil prices, but also on basic metals. Over the years, commodities is expected to do fine as an asset class, but not in 2014. Last year, people were saying, why do we own REITs? They're not going anywhere. This year, people were saying, how come we don't own more in the REIT class? They're doing great. Well, we own some. When it's not doing well, we'll rebalance into it. When it's done great, like it did this year, we'll rebalance back to where we think it ought to be, which is what we do for all our asset classes. Come and see us, Envision Wealth Planning. Glad to help.